beer. You must start off with a dog beer, mate. Rogers, from Little Creatures, Fremantle. The dogs live across this place. It's called Roger, and that's why this is called dog beer. It's Rogers. You got that?
And not you, Roger.
Not you.
I didn't give him a chance to start talking.
It's fine.
Then you take aluminium foil, about this long. You tear it off.
Is it South African or Australian?
Australian. Foot. You can make it 1.5 foot. And then you take another piece. Just check it's more or less the same length. That doesn't need to be all that accurate. Flatten it out nicely. Put a little bit of this very special salt. You can only get this in Perth, in a place called
IGA.
And it's called seafood, lemon and
dill.
Is that right?
Dill.
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 Thank you. And then you also need a grinder. And there's a grinder. Grind it.
She's a very good grinder, and her name is Madeleine.
Yeah.
You have to come back.
And we have,
then you take a little
we have audience. Trainee chefs.
Take a little bit of garlic that Margaret has crushed for us.
Yes.
Very, very nice. She did an excellent job with that. And then you need some special butter and some crushed
onion
as well. And you just take a piece of butter around about 3 millimeters thick and put it on top of that.
Very healthy.
And then you can also put, if you want to, this is very important, a little bit of specially Spencer's lemon pepper seasoning. You can only buy this also in a place called North Perth Beach. In Perth. Then the salmon is very important. You must buy these cuts. That's got the thin piece on the side. You don't need to take the skin off. And you put that down like that. Very important. And then you take some lemon juice. Lemon juice is also specially pressed out and squeezed out by a lady called Margaret Constantaris. Is that right?
Constantara.
Constantara, okay. Then you can put a little bit of lemon pepper.
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 No, not pepper, pepper.
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 A little bit of onion, that's very important. Then you take a few prawnies, like these size.
Are they Australian prawns?
Australian prawns are very important. Not fresh water, must be sea ones. And you put 1, 2, 3, 4 on there. And you make sure that you don't take everything because you have to cook some for Spiros afterwards. Then on top of that, you take a little bit of this very special lemon and...
grounded by...
by Madeleine.
The grinder.
And you just throw that on top of that.
Yes.
Very important.
It looks like a lot of pepper.
It's a little
spices.
Bit, you'll see it, that fish.
And butter again.
A little bit of butter on top. You'll see just now the butter is actually going to be the sauce for the small potatoes. Then what's important?
Lemon.
A little bit more lemon. So you just need to put some lemon on the prawns as well.
And you don't do garlic twice?
You can if you want to. In this case, I'm going to do it just to finish the last bit. Nothing wrong with that. You can do it as much as you like. Garlic is very
just in
lovely.
Case. Spiro likes his prawns there. He can have another
one
there.
Put that one on that side. And then you just need to dry your hands. This is important. Otherwise, you won't be able to fold up this aluminium foil. Put it up nicely. Be very careful.
You forgot the barbecue sauce.
We won't do that today. You don't have to go through a lot of effort. Just fold it so it's closed and find out where's the lowest point like that. Don't fold it too much and let's do that. Fold it in and close it and make it a little basket.
Yay!
That's all.
Iron
then
chef.
You put
Jan.
This in the cob cooker outside and you will cook this for around about 15 minutes. And what's the secret, if you just hold your hand there, you can actually feel all the fish there on the side. You can feel it's cold now on your finger. When it's cooked and you can feel that it's hot, very, very hot on your finger, now, then you know it's actually cooked through.
Ah, interesting.
Yeah. Then you take them off and you let them stand outside. You're not in the wind, it cools it down too quickly. Just in a little tray for about 15 to 20 minutes, you're ready to eat. And we'll show you just now how you eat it. You don't take it out of the foil. You actually put the foil in your plate. You open it up very carefully. You take your small potatoes. You put it inside there. You can squeeze it if you want to. And you eat it out of this aluminium foil.
Wow. But you're going to be around to eat it, aren't you?
Most probably I will have 4 of them. And I hope there's something left for you as well.
Yes. You know you've got a brother that looks like you in this country. His name is William Eofels. Eofels.
Yeah.